to build one of these lawn chairs from the plans from my website, and I've also printed out some one-to-one templates for some of the shapes using my big print program, and I've got my wood here, and I set up my small bandsaw outside because I want to build this outside because it's nice today. I'm going to start out by building these side frames. There's a segmented curve right about here, and I'm just going to mark the positions for these segments are. So the first one's 1.1 centimeters deep, and the second spot is 1.6 deep. I'm just going to use that first piece to mark the other three pieces I need to cut out. This cheap bandsaw blade has very little set to it, which means it's terrible at cutting curves, but it does cut super clean. These legs are just one cedar 2x6 ripped down the middle, and I'm just going to get the angle from here and mark that on the ends. If you're going to build a lot of lawn chairs, it makes sense to build a jig like I have a picture of in the plans. But I'm only going to build one this time, so I'm just going to line these up carefully with my one-to-one printout as I nail them together. So there's another two pieces that go on here, but before I nail those on, I'm going to use this piece here as a jig to make sure my other frame is going to be identical to this one. Next, I'm going to build this frame for the back, which supports all the boards that go onto it, and it needs this complicated shape for these things here, and I already made myself a template by making a one-to-one printout of that part here, so I don't have to draw these complicated arcs. I need to cut some dados in these long pieces here, right here. And I've jigged this up so that I can cut the dados with my circular saw. A good method for spacing these evenly would be just to make some spacers that all fit in here, but I can't be bothered to make any, so I'm just kind of trying to arrange these by eye so that they're all about the same, and I'm just going to tack these in slightly. just line them up with the old nail holes and they'll be in exactly the right spot. One thing I forgot to add earlier is this block that goes in here for nailing the back onto, just to get more support. For the back angle, I recommend you do a trowel assembly with clamps, just to make sure you actually like the angle, because there's different reclines that work best. But I already know this angle is on my other lawn chair, and I like that one, so I'm just going to do that without a trowel fit. And this corner should be flush with the bottom edge here, and this on the back corner here. It's important to test fit this on a level surface so that the chair doesn't end up rocking, but I still need to get the glue into those joints before I nail them. Now I just have to line it up with the old nail holes and I'll have the perfect alignment. Well, I'm taking a break from the project because it's raining. There's my bandsaw covered up and I got my lawn chair stashed in my shed, so at least that's not getting wet. Well, at least that rain didn't last all day. I cut this bevel inside on the table saw and then I used my bevel gauge to check what the next mating bevel is that I needed for the next board. And I cut that board on the table saw, and before I nail this one on, I'm going to cut another bevel on here to match with the next board. Got the mating bevel cut on this one, now I just need to mark where I got to cut away for the legs. This last board gets a bit tricky. Depending on the slope that you picked for your back, this may or may not work out very well. So this board needs to get cut away a bit so that it moves into here, and it needs to move back by about this much to make room for this board. So I'm just going to use a compass to mark an offset what I need to cut off. So I cut away quite a bit of that last board and I'm just going to strengthen it a bit by gluing it to the second last board, so they're going to be like one board. Interruptions for rain and noisy neighbors and overhead planes. It took me about 5 hours to build this chair, but with all the breaks, I was starting to run out of daylight, but it's all done now.